Palworld has it all. Combat, farming, crafting, collecting, and exploration are some key features in this open-world survival game where you live alongside adorable and deadly creatures called pals. With so much to do in this game, there are plenty of options on how to start your adventure. Here are 7 things to do first in Palworld to set you up for success in surviving the first night. Though you're free to explore the world around you for hidden treasures and collectibles, the initial tasks in Palworld are a great starting point. First, you'll need to gather materials to build useful items for survival. Find at least 2 pieces of wood on the ground, or punch trees to collect. You can also head north from your starting point in the Plateau of Beginnings to find an expedition survivor who will give you 10 wood. While you're there, be sure to unlock fast travel at the Great Eagle statue to acquire 1 technology point. Now you're ready to build a primitive workbench where you can craft a variety of items. You can place the workbench anywhere for now. You'll be able to disassemble it and retrieve materials back at any time. Technology points allow you to unlock crafting and building recipes as you progress. You'll earn these points by leveling up and unlocking fast travel points at the Great Eagle statues. Spend your first 6 technology points on the Pal Box for setting up your base, the Pal Sphere for catching pals, the Campfire for providing warmth and the ability to cook food, the Wooden Chest for storing materials, and the Wooden Structure Set for building a house. Now that you've unlocked Pal Spheres, it's time to catch pals to help you survive. If you're lucky, you might find Pal Spheres on the ground or in treasure chests scattered throughout the world, but you'll likely need to craft these items, which require 3 wood, 3 stone, and 1 paldium fragment. Find these materials on the ground or continue punching rocks. Paldium can be gathered from the small sparkling blue rocks. Once you gather the required materials, head to your primitive workbench and craft Pal Spheres. There are a few options for pals in this initial area, but Kativa is a very useful pal to have around because of their cat helper partner skills that helps carry supplies to increase your max carrying capacity. Additionally, Kativa has multiple uses for your base to assist with building and crafting, transporting goods, collecting crops for farming, and mining stone and ore. Note that Kativa will run away from you when you get close. One way to catch Kativa is to corner it in an area, then attack to weaken it and throw your Pal Sphere to attempt to catch it. Be careful if you're in an area with multiple Kativa because the others will turn aggressive and attack you. With your first pal caught, it's time to build your base. You want to build your first base in a flat, open area near resources. There are multiple spots north of the starting area to choose from. You might consider finding a spot a little bit away from a fast travel statue because you'll also be able to fast travel to your base. You'll be able to unlock the ability to create multiple bases later on, so don't stress too much about it as long as you have nearby resources to gather. Once you have a good spot for base building, access your build menu to find the Pal Box. You'll need 1 paldium fragment, 8 wood, and 3 stone to build it. If you have Kativa or any other pal that has the handiwork suitability out of their pal sphere, then they will assist you while building structures in your base. You can also assign a pal to work on your base by accessing the Pal Box management menu. Kativa will often get straight to mining nearby rocks. Now that you have a base location, you can start building a house, storage chest, and campfire. These structures require lots of wood, so it's best to craft tools to help you gather wood and stone more efficiently than punching trees and rocks. Make sure you have a workbench in the area to craft items if you set up your base away from your initial workbench spot. Start with crafting a stone axe, which requires 5 wood and 5 stone. The axe will let you chop trees to gather wood and fiber more quickly. Gather more wood with the axe if needed to also build a stone pickaxe for mining. Holding on to all these resources will weigh you down, so you'll want to build a wooden chest for storing materials to avoid encumbrance. Place the chest in a location near your resources. This is helpful for pals to carry items to the chest without needing to walk far. As you expend energy during the day, your hunger meter will deplete. You can restore this bar by consuming food. Find food by gathering berries from nearby bushes or by drops from pals you attack. You'll have an option to eat these items from your inventory. Note that food rots over time and will vanish when they spoil. Eventually, you'll be able to store items in a cooler to prevent rotting. Your pals also have their own hunger meter that needs to be replenished as they provide labor on the base. At level 4, you'll be able to unlock a feed box with technology points where you can place food for your pals to automatically eat at the base when they're hungry. Finally, you need to make sure you have a way to survive your first night. You'll either need a source of warmth or a bed to sleep through the night. Craft a handheld torch if you want to use the least amount of resources. It only requires 2 wood and 2 stone. The torch is also useful if you want to explore on foot at night. You can also build a campfire to provide warmth and a way to cook food to replenish your hunger faster. Alternatively, you can unlock and craft cloth to make a cloth outfit, which requires wool. Wool drops from Lamball when you attack them. The cloth outfit protects against cold at night so you can explore and hunt down those nocturnal pals. If you want to craft a bed and skip nighttime entirely, you also need to build a structure with a roof. Unlock the shoddy bed at level 3 in your technology menu and build it using 20 wood, 5 fiber, and 1 wool. While you're spending technology points, also be sure to unlock the straw pal bed so your pals at base can recover at night. And that's 7 things to do first in Palworld to survive your first night. For more tips and tricks on Palworld, head on over to IGN.com to check out our growing wiki guide. And for everything else video games, stick with IGN.